Hello guys, and welcome back to Your Universe. I know it's been a while since I made a video, and recently the great news of the Demeter update. I was really wondering whether I should continue making these videos, and I did conclude that the pinching method and all those checkerboards will still be very useful after the update. It will still be an extremely fast way of manipulating vertices. I believe will be faster in some cases than the vertex editor. When you precisely know what you want to do, it will be faster, and the vertices editor will not. It will not also help you create random shapes, random creation. It will be something very precise when you have already in mind the position of each vertices. So today I would like to talk about the library I just posted on DU creators. So I called it the Ultimate Voxel for Library, and I'm going to introduce you which every parts. So we'll be starting by my complete library of checkerboards. Four lines. The two first lines are from. They are all. Two first lines are all the voxel of 1 by 1 by z, and z on the positive numbers. And the center voxel is at the bottom. So it's 1 by 1 by z. Here even goes to some inverted one. And the two lines above have their center, have the voxel centered in the middle. So extending on both sides. Here is just extending on z plus, and here z plus and minus at the same time. So you have all of them. And all those being extracted from collection of, this is all the possible 1 by 1 by z possible positions and thickness and height of the so I made it this little curve library, and I extracted all those are the important ones. The others are just look cool, may help in some cases, but the important ones are here on those lines. So those are the full one. This is 1 by 1 by 1 on every positions it can be, and those are the 1 by 1 by z was the bottom of the 1 by 1, always at the same position, just the increasing positive values. And here is the 0.5, same as the 1 by 1 by 1. So here is the 1 by 1 by half. And this library especially, I made it for the half and the quarter of voxels. So you will find various, quite a lot of different pre-made shapes, triangles or whatever, all what you need to work for making construct was half and quarter of voxels. So you have all the corners, the full one, long one, short one. Here are all the connection parts. So the corners when you want to connect one bar with another one, but you don't want to put the little square one, so you want a smooth corner, So here you can have this triangle corner. Here's a 3D pyramidal corner. They have all different types of corners and position. They may not look like in build mode, look very good, but when you leave the build mode, they will smooth angles out. Especially for this piece, because this piece is 7 sides instead of 6. So you will find all what you need in order to build with smaller voxels. Building with smaller voxels might be long, but the looking of a finished construct made by those it's definitely different. So it was really worth the try. Not giving up on those techniques. And here I had a couple of them are extra large one, can be used mainly for making others, for controlling vertices of those that are not here. So those are also very useful. The black one, you can use it for making reactors, for making shapes I haven't made. And the last, and I will not talk about it today too much, but here those panels, which are tools for making joint panels with joints, floors, and with little gaps. So just giving you here some examples to use, but I will do a part 2 to explain how to make them and how to adjust them and how to use them. So right now we're going to focus on this library, and I do have a specific example, a little workshop we can do together so you understand how to use the pieces. And we're going to passing by my last excess little ship, call it GigaChad. I made exclusively out of those pieces. So it's all, everything, well, not those panels, you shutters, you know them. If you follow my video before, I explain how to make them. But the rest is the white part also. The white part, no, but the blue and the red, all is made from this library. So it's all 0.5 half voxels or what shapes. They're half, they're not full voxels. Giving enough details to a small construct like this one, and the result is just astonishing. I really like what I did. Can see it's all 0.5. I didn't go smaller. 0.5 is just perfect scale for this kind of build. And I think there's a lot of things to do. It's very, very good for building on XS and S creations. So let's go to the practical part. I'm going to my new build. It's a barge. Well, wait for it. It's for now 100% microvoxels. So 100% smaller than, all of them are smaller than half a voxel. Or smaller than a full voxel. There is no regular voxel at all in this build. And I was about to build my piloting cabin when I got interested into those crappy elements, canopies, which are extremely badly designed. And everyone has noticed that you cannot stack them on each other. You cannot even. Well, they're bad. They're very bad. The work behind is atrocious. Probably done by an intern, but when you want to, I don't know, make a canopy and stack them beside each other, you cannot. So you have to space them, and in order to space them, you have to fill in those gaps, right? So today we're going very fast. How to use the library to make a couple shapes to help you fill in those gaps. So we're starting by doing those one by one slope. So they're 45 degree slope, using half voxel, quarter voxel. So we will start by first taking one piece of what we want, and we can find it here. It's a 45 degree half a voxel. Where can I put it? Okay, I'll put it here. Change its color. Right. And I want it have half the height of it. So how can I do? I need reactors for that. So I need some other pieces from here to reduce the size of it. So here, very simple. So we need to stick another one. Here we need to stick either a bar like this on top, yeah, like this, holding shift, hold shift, and I come modify the corner. I bring it up, so I got this shape. Let's paste it at the bottom, because we need now a shape to fill in between. So underneath this one, we need another shape to link from this corner to this corner. So let's see. Let's try with this again. And it's not the right shape, but you will understand what we're trying to do. So I need, okay, no, let's go up, yeah, like this. So here I have three corners that are good. One, two, three, four. So 1, 2, and 4 are good corners. And I need to bring this corner, this three, up until here somewhere. So there are multiple solutions. Well, the fastest solution is to find a piece that we already have that fill in this part. So we need to find a triangle piece that has this corner already here. So a simple this, I'm going to cancel it. We'll look into the triangles, but not this triangle, because this triangle doesn't have its corner, or the 90 degree corner align with the border of the voxel. So I have one here. Yes. Okay. Now we're good. Where is my shape? Rotate it. Oh, it's perfect. Here. Change the color. And you see, here as one, corner one, corner two, corner three is here, and corner four is here. So the corner four, the corner three, corner two, three, four are aligned perfectly. So when I will pass it, the corner four will come, get stretched to fit the. So we here have our first two pieces of our slope, and this is a stackable, so you can put them one after another. You can stack them. So it just does like that. I just put 1, 2, 3, 4. It's very easy. Up, up, up. Okay, you see? We met in 5 seconds. Well, in 2 minutes. These two shapes. We realized that the frame of that canopy is going up a little bit. So we are going to adjust a tiny bit the corner of this gray one, and we'll be trying to raise it up a tiny bit. We'll need to adjust this one, this corner, and this corner. We raise up. So how we can raise them up? Okay, this corner is here, so we need one piece that will help us push it up. What's that we need? Of course, we need checkers, and here our checker boards can be useful. So we had our corner here, and we want to push it up a little bit more, so we'll be taking just the shape above it. Or we can take this one. Let me see, the two. Yes, the shape right underneath the two. And no, we're not taking the shape, we take the checker board. Raise it, pull out your smooth tool, and pinch me that right in the middle. Hold out. Yeah. Okay. Some directions are a little bit annoying, so we try a different orientation of the panel and try again. No. Okay, here works once, only once, because we have here a desired. Oh, where is my good side? Yeah, here. The desired. 0.5 by 0.5 by another certain length, and let me rotate that one. Yeah, like this. All right. So I'm not moving it, I just use the arrows to lock it, and you can see if I press shift, this gray one is going to raise up. No, my mistake. It's not a lost piece. Let's do let's do with that one. Okay, 1, 2, okay, yeah. Precise. Okay. I'm sorry. All right, now we're good. Oh, stupid or what? Okay, I need the one smaller, which is this one. Sorry. Okay, here we go. Okay, so we have raised up a tiny bit this corner. And with the lever we have, we don't have intermediate size, but I think that will look good. And now we need to raise this size, this side. So this side, how do we do that? How about we can use the one, of course. Can use the first one. We can use the first one that we made. So it's not a lost. So it's the one just smaller than two by one. Here we go. You see, and it's going to raise it up. And here, my shape, amazing. Alright, we come past this on top. And yes, look at that. It's almost perfect. Well, I feel it's better going out when your frame is going out than before when it was making this little gap. It definitely looks better, so that's what I did on the other side. And well, this is a render bug, so that does the job, I guess. That does a real good job. For two species, I just used a long piece, so I don't have interference. I have a long piece of 1 by 0.5 by 2, and that doesn't interfere with this angle. You can add something clean on the inside and on the outside. And there is one piece where you're going to you're going to have troubles, is this corner piece. So let me show you. We'll do that together, and we'll do that together. It's very easy. So how is the setup? Okay, so one like this. And one like this. Alright. Now we have a little problem here. But there is an easy fix. Easy fix. And you need. Let's see. Is that this piece? It's a flat little corner one. And you come up. This. No. do I have here? Oh no, I remember. I need to push a 1.5. I need to push a 1.5 like this. This is bishop piece. Oh yeah, that was that. Neat. Oh yeah, that's this one. I need to push a 1.5. With a 2.5. So I have one 2.5 here. You also have a 2.5. Not here, but you have one. Here. Okay, here. 1, 2, 2.5. Okay. Alright, I have my piece. This. So you put the 2.5 pointing upward underneath, you press shift, and you end up with a piece, very tiny offset flat piece, which where the center is here. Then you bring this piece here up and this corner. Is it? Yes. Okay, making it orange. And here you go. You have fixed a corner angle, and you can use it for your corners. The rest are just triangle pieces. Triangle pieces. Okay, here is 1.5. Oh, this one is a normal one. Well, you guys understood the principle of it. This was a difficult piece, and this one, once you have this is quite easy to do the rest. All right, so for now, let's end this video and see you at the second part. Fly safe.